بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته We thank and praise the Almighty Allah for having given us the opportunity to connect to each other at this given time wherever we may be connecting to each other from May the Almighty Allah bless us protect each one of us May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the full blessings of the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us to witness the completion of the month of Ramadan and may He make us among those who witness the month of Ramadan and benefit from it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us among those who witness the month of Ramadan and yet do not attain the forgiveness of Him. On this 20th day of Ramadan, I would want us to look at the last 10 days of Ramadan and the virtues that come with it. The last 10 days of Ramadan are days wherein the Muslims would observe the Sunnah i'tikaf. There are three types of i'tikaf. One is wajib i'tikaf, secondly Sunnah i'tikaf, and thirdly nafl i'tikaf. When we talk of wajib i'tikaf, it is an i'tikaf that is as a result of one having, for example, made a vow that if such and such a thing happens, I would make an i'tikaf. For example, if you are a student who is writing exams, you say, if I pass my exams, I will make i'tikaf for 3 days. When your results come out and you pass your exams, it becomes wajib upon you to make sure that you perform the wajib i'tikaf. And that's the seclusion in the masjid. And that seclusion, it will entail that you will have to fast during the day and it will have to be a minimum of 1 day and one night. So for the wajib i'tikaf, you can't do it for few minutes. It has to be a minimum of 1 day and one night. Then you have a nafl i'tikaf. Nafl i'tikaf is what we do almost on a daily basis. When we enter into the masjid, we are taught to make a dua that nawaitul i'tikaf ma dumtu fil masjid. I make an intention of being in i'tikaf in the masjid so long as I am in the masjid. So perhaps you went in the masjid for your fajr salah or your dhuhr, asr, maghrib or isha salah. You should make an intention that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treat every moment of yours in the masjid as an i'tikaf for you. And then we have a sunnah i'tikaf, which is the example of the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan. And this i'tikaf, it is sunnah to observe it. And for us in Southern Africa, here it will begin after Maghrib Salah of today. And it will last until the end of Ramadan. And in this Sunnah i'tikaf, the history of it tells its importance. It is said that one day Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam came out in order to inform the believers of the night of power, the night of Dikri or Laylatul Qadr. Then he found some Sahaba who were engaged in some arguments. And because of the arguments, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the knowledge of the exact date of Laylatul Qadr was taken away by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a result, we have to seek Laylatul Qadr in the last 10 days of Ramadan during the odd nights of these last 10 days of the month of Ramadan. So the primary objective of us going into this i'tikaf of the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan is for us to seek Laylatul Qadr, so that when the Laylatul Qadr comes, we'll be in the masjid and engaged in the ibadah and worship of the Almighty Allah. I make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us all an opportunity to spend nights and days of the last 10 days of Ramadan while we are in i'tikaf. And this i'tikaf comes with it with, you know, a lot of benefits and a lot of virtues. It comes with a lot of tremendous benefits and virtues. We know that one who will perform the i'tikaf will get the benefits of the reward of somebody who would have performed two Hajj and two Umrahs. We also know that it comes in a hadith that Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whosoever will perform i'tikaf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put three trenches. He will place three trenches between him and the fire of Jahannam. And it is said that the distance will be equal to the distance of between the heavens and the earth. And also, when a person performs i'tikaf, he will get the reward of equal to all those that will be doing other acts of ibadah, which one is unable to perform as a result of him being in the masjid and in seclusion performing i'tikaf. We also know that when a person is in i'tikaf, he is saved and protected from many sins that would be as a result of a person who is outside the masjid. Because when we are outside the masjid, we come through a lot of trials and temptations, and sometimes we fall to those temptations and we end up sinning against the Almighty Allah, which a person who will be in itikaf will be protected from. So we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from sins of all kinds. Itikaf is very important for us, because this sunnah itikaf especially is very important, because it is fard, it is sunnah mu'akkada ala al-kifaya, which means that if the whole locality, no one sits in the masjid for itikaf, that whole community is cursed and it is liable to a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if at least one person sits in itikaf during the last 10 days of Ramadan in a locality, then that person has exempted the whole community from the punishment and the case of the Almighty Allah. And the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us these last 10 days of Ramadan to perform itikaf in it is so that we can benefit from the Laylatul Qadr. The Laylatul Qadr will come whilst we are in the masjid making ibadah of Allah. We all know that when a person is in itikaf, there are actions that they are supposed to be doing and actions which they are not supposed to be doing. For instance, when you are in the masjid in itikaf, how do you spend your nights and day? You spend your nights and day performing the fard salah, the sunnah salah, the nafil salah. You read the Quran, recitation of the Holy Quran. You make dhikr, or you can, even your sleeping, your resting and your silence, your moments when you are not doing anything, it is also considered as ibadah because you are in itikaf. So the moments that one spends in itikaf is a very important moment. You also make dua during those moments. So when the night of Qadr comes, definitely you would be among those people who would be found in the ibadah and worship of the Almighty Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in the Holy Quran that inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr, laylatul wama adraka ma laylatul qadr, laylatul qadr khayrun min alf shahr. That indeed we send down the Quran on the night of Qadr, the night of decree and power. And what is it that will show you that then what the night of power and decree is? Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. The night of decree and power is more than 1,000 months, and 1,000 months is equal to 83 years. And which means that a person who engage in ibadah and worship of the Almighty Allah during the night of Qadr, he will get the reward equal to a person who would have spent 83 years of their life in the worship of the Almighty Allah. So that's a tremendous achievement in terms of the blessings of the Almighty Allah. And we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allahumma ballighna laylatul qadr. Ya Allah, convey upon us this laylatul qadr. And Ya Allah, forgive us. And Ya Allah, make our lives pleasing to you. And make us love such things that make us closer to you. And make us to detest such things that draw us away from you. And when we happen to meet the Laylatul Qadr, the dua that we must pray is as taught to us by Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That when you make dua on Laylatul Qadr, the best dua that you make is Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. That Ya Allah, you are most pardoning and you love to pardon, so pardon us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardon each one of us. The pardon of Allah is much needed by us. We know that there are two different ways the Almighty Allah will clear us from our sins, from the repercussions of our sins. One is through forgiveness. The Almighty Allah will forgive us. When we ask for His forgiveness, He will grant it to us. But on the day of Qiyamah, it will be shown to us that we did such and such and it was forgiven of us. But the second type is afu, which is the pardon of the Almighty Allah. And the pardon of the Almighty Allah is such that when Allah pardons a sin of His servant, He will make that sin not to be remembered by anyone or anything else. Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will make Himself not to remind that servant of His of that sin, and He will make that servant of His to forget that sin, and even the place where that sin was committed will be made to forget that particular sin. The limbs that committed that sin will be made to forget about that sin. So a person who earns the pardon of the Almighty Allah is like a person who never committed that sin at all. So Allah will never remind us of that sin. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon us. And we do that by making abundance of this dua. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. O Allah, You are the most pardoning. You love to pardon. Please pardon us. Ja'alana Allahu wa iyyakum min alladhina yastami'una al-qawl fayattabi'una ahsanahu wa ashkurukum ala husni istima'ikum. Until we meet again, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.